It was a time when the game was plenty and the wardens were few. Being in trouble might mean that you got caught snatching a freshly baked pie from a window sill. Being in serious trouble might mean that you got caught necking after 11:30 p.m. on Graveyard Hill. Out on the ranches where we grew up, the doors were left unlocked. Underage driving was often required to help support the family farm. We were a tight-knit class of all-American cowboys and cowgirls that worked hard and played hard. We were all truly blessed to have grown up in such a magical time and place. My name is Tillman Turley, a proud member of the Round Valley High School, Springerville, Eager, Arizona class of 1955, and this is our story.
Round Valley is the area which sits between the cities of Springerville and Eager, beneath the White Mountains of northeastern Arizona. Springerville was originally established in 1879. The city of Eager was named for the Eager family, who homesteaded this area in the late 1800s. Other surrounding cities include Greer, Nutrioso, and Alpine, Arizona.
When I was just a little girl, I ask my mother, what will I be? Will I be pretty? Will I be rich? Here's what she said to me.
Well, one day we didn't have anything to do at Minnie Mae's house, and so these three boys came by in our class, or maybe one class ahead of us, and we decided we were going to give them permanence, and we did. We permed, whose was it? Do you remember? Wasn't one a Rogers boy?
We permed Donnie Lester's
David
hair.
David Rogers?
No, we permed Donnie Lester's hair.
We did three.
Because he was talking about that today. Mm-hmm. And his wife said, oh, maybe that's why you don't have any hair much left. But
I remember, Carolyn, I started at Round Valley High School when I was sophomore, and I just sort of learning everyone, and I just remember Carolyn was a very dynamic young slip of a lady.
We always had little fights because we just were such good friends, you know, you just have to fight. And we'd get really mad that time.
So anyway, we went to the same church, and
we hadn't spoken at least a month or two.
It was probably so insignificant.
Yeah.
But it was a big deal to us, I guess, mm-hmm. because we were little, and I think we were still in grammar school at this time. And
my mother ordered me a beautiful blue suit out of the Montgomery Ward catalog. It was very nice. It was blue, and it had a flower right here or something, and a little blue skirt and everything, and anyway, it was Easter Sunday, and I went to church, and of course it was full on Easter Sunday, and I was sitting, and the only seat empty in the whole church was next to me, and Minnie Mae comes in, and she's like, right now she's my sworn enemy, you know. She comes in, and she comes around, and she comes and sits in that seat beside me wearing that same blue suit that her mom had to order from the same catalog, and so we just like looked at each other with daggers, and we're just like, and then pretty soon we just thought, this is the funniest thing ever, and we started laughing, and we're laughing in Easter Sunday service. We couldn't stop giggling, and we got back together as friends again.
We didn't have school buses then, so we had to walk wherever we went.
That's right, we walked to school.
Yeah. We walked to the games, we walked everywhere.
A white sport coat and a pink carnation. I'm all dressed up for the dance. A white sport coat and a pink carnation. I'm all alone in romance.
I got a story I want to tell you, and I'm pretty sure these two guys was with me. Back when we were in high school, we used to appropriate chickens once in a while to have a chicken fry. So we decided we were going to go out and get some chickens. So we went and called the deputy sheriff. I don't want to mention his name because some of his descendants still alive. Told him there'd been a car wreck outside of town. We went up and stole his chickens. Took them out and ate them. A little later on, we went down to my uncle's house, going to get some more chickens. And I was in the chicken coop passing the chickens out. And I don't remember who I was passing them to. But my uncle come out and these two guys split off and left me. My uncle was taking the chickens as I was passing them back and turning them loose. Pretty quick he says, "Leon, don't you think you got enough?"
Well, we kept things going. I can remember one time when we were in high school, a bunch of us decided to go up the river. And we decided we would get some fish by an illegal method. And one of us was to throw a half a stick of dynamite in the river. Now, to make this really good, my grandfather was a state game warden. And I knew that if I got involved something like that, he'd kill me. And so when they started to throw the dynamite in the river, I ducked back in the bushes. Well, there was a lady named Nina Franklin who was a barber's wife, and she was an avid fisherman. And she heard the first half stick go off, and she went down the river to see what was going on. And she saw the boys that were out by the riverside throwing the dynamite in, and so she went in and turned them all over to the judge. And, of course, everybody's name was there except mine, so they knew that I was the one that had gone home and said to my grandfather, "These boys did this." And I said, "No, I was not involved in that." But nobody believed me until they went to court and they brought her in as the person that had seen all this happen. Then they believed me after that. But It was kind of a hairy situation.
Then the other one was fun. We had, can't remember what we called it, but it was basketball also. But we had one hand, you had a boxing glove on one hand. And so anytime you had the ball, people could hit you with their boxing glove. And so, you know, you didn't really want the ball. But somebody would walk over, and naturally you just reach out, and they would hand you the ball, and then they would hit you in the face. So that was always kind of a fun one. But, and I need to say that all those folks that have preceded me on the tape, whatever they said about me was not true. Jimmy, Leon, they all lie. They've been lying for years.
Just before Tillman became the quarterback, Tommy Finch was the quarterback, and he got his shoulder hurt quite badly. And so Tillman became the quarterback. Tillman was a lot larger than me, and I was way downfield, and Tillman broke through the line, and he was going full blast, and it was just me to stop him. I knew I had to step in front of him. He ran right over me, but I tackled him. But all we had for a field in those days was just a rocky ground. There was no grass, and there were small pebbles. And I remember all the side of my left forehead was bleeding when I got up from tackling Tillman.
All right. My name's Tillman Turley, and this is LaVon Weigel.
Butler.
And we were classmates. But we were more than classmates. LaVon and I were the best of friends. We both had lovers in other towns. So if we needed to go somewhere, we would hook up and go so that we could stay...
Tillman, that the thing is, Irv was a senior when we were freshmen.
Right.
And I started going with him immediately when I became a freshman, which is really unbelievable. But you were my age too, so you couldn't drive yet.
Right.
And so he drove us.
That's right. Everywhere. So we had to drive in the back seat. And I was dating a little beautiful little blonde named Judy Stammer.
Who wasn't in high school yet. She was 8th grade.
She was 8th grade.
Mm-hmm. And she was one of my best friends.
And we double dated all the time.
Them in the back seat.
We had fun. We didn't even know how to kiss yet. You know, we just put our lips together and experiment.
Right after we was married, of course, we just out of high school then. And we lived in an apartment there in Springerville. And about 10 o'clock at night, well, I heard a knock on the door, and there was T-Bone, and I can't remember if Richard was with him, but Hall Ashcroft, and I think Bud Davis, and here they come in with some turkeys. Of course, they had went and poached some turkeys, and they brought them down to my house, wanting Kay to cook them. So she bailed and we all ate turkey. The best kind, the poached kind.
You betcha.
When the warm south wind blows, every cowboy knows, spring around up time is finally here.
The rodeo was just one of the greatest recreations for the whole Round Valley area. And I always look forward to the 4th of July because my cousin was in the rodeo, and a lot of people in Springerville and the whole surrounding area knew my cousin, and he liked to rope. And we always, I either rode in the parade on a horse or with my cousin.
I loved rodeo, and I did quite a bit of racing on some horses that my dad did, and we all loved rodeo. And I remember that we had really a fast horse we called Old Red, and he was getting a little older, and Jimmy Whiting in our class was riding his uncle's Big Bay. And my horse could start really fast, and he could go a short distance ahead of the rest. But Jimmy's uncle knew that if they made the race just a little longer, that big long-legged bay would overtake my horse. And so they started at just a little different spot than usual, and it was right just at the end. Jimmy just necked out by neck my horse.
I won the calf roping championship at a major rodeo in California.
Did you ever get really hurt?
At that rodeo, I had rode a Brahma, and there were big ones. And I fell below him, and he stepped on my right calf, and I couldn't walk good for about six months. Just the calf was just so badly, bruised. And I quit riding bulls, but that was the same day I won the calf championship. And that's about 10,000 in attendance. That's a pretty good-sized rodeo.
I went to school in the Valley and lived there part-time, lived in Greer, different places, and I wanted to live up here all the time. Where a lot of the kids up here wanted to live down the Valley all the time. But I love the big families, and I like to rodeo. I like to run the barrels, and I like that kind of lifestyle.
Especially the dances. The dances were the that's what we look forward to most of all. Up in the
Arvizona.
Tillman, I remember he was a great dancer.
We loved to
and
dance.
I loved to dance with Tillman. Mm.
He used to dance with Donnie Lester sometimes. Remember when they'd get going? They would do it just really double time around the floor, for a joke.
Listen.
He's a good dancer.
Donnie Lester and I, in a good Western dance, in a big hall, like a church, a big multi-purpose room, we could go around that hall five times.
While
the rest
together.
Of the guys would go around twice. We could dance.
That was so funny.
I mean, we could jitterbug and move like you can't believe. And that was, I would have to say, next to sports, the dancing with all the good-looking women in Round Valley.
We loved the dance.
His dad used to come up from the Valley, so.
And I never knew she existed till about 3 or 4 months before I married her, so.
Well, everybody said he was an old man, and everybody said I was.
She was 16, by the way, when I married her.
Well, now I turned 17 on our honeymoon. So.
That's right.
That's right.
You were 16.
Right.
And everybody says, well, I married you and then raised you the way I wanted to, and I'd done a poor job.
That's right.
Well, let me tell you, the first time I ever saw her was freshman initiation. In those days, they initiated pretty heavily, but if I'm remembering right, for some reason, she wore some little pinkish red long-handled underwears for initiation. And some of my friends, as we got acquainted with the new incoming freshman, some of them remarked, well, that's a pretty good-looking gal. I poo-pooed it. But over time, for some reason, why it changed, and I kind of took an interest.
Minnie May. You know this woman is phenomenal. Well, I don't know whether they told you or not it about, but we considered her a traitor back in high school. She was going with a boy from St. John's. And she made the mistake of wearing his red Letterman sweater to school one day.
To my surprise, all the Lettermen at Round Valley High School were very upset.
So we took that sweater off of her, sewed a big yellow stripe down the back of it, and mailed it back to St. John's.
Yes. finally, I don't know what happened, but I did get it back.
We taught her a lesson, we thought. Well, you know, we didn't teach many anyway.
I forgot a lot of this
stuff. We were characters.
Right.
Do you
Tillman
agree?
Just told the story, too.
Oh, he did?
Yeah.
How many of us are
15.
How many of you can 15? Still sing the school song?
15.
Is that all? Deep in the valley was a school we loved so well. Round Valley High School, must we say farewell? We are sons and daughters, lift our voices to the sky, and the hills re-echo, sending back the cry. RV, Round Valley High School, our water proud are we. RV, Round Valley High School, my sons and daughters to me.
Hey, how about that?
Yeah, begin, begin.
I remember when we were in high school playing football, we had a play, I guess the one, it's the one called the Elk. This is a play with a center.
We had a play where I was the center, and when I centered the ball, I would put it behind my left leg, and Clifford Hale had moved up to be the guard position. He was normally a halfback.
He just passed it around his leg to the person next to him, which was the fastest person on our team. And we'd all go through a lot of fakes and so forth.
And they'd stand there for a while, and then the guy would take off and score a touchdown. And any experienced referees would have caught it right away. But we did that for, I guess we probably scored about 10 touchdowns against some of the lesser teams before they figured it out.
One time in Holbrook, we had the referees tell us that they knew that we were using an illegal play, and they knew what it was. And we ran that about three times, and they never did catch it.
He's just an awesome guy as far as I'm concerned. I'm glad I'm a better man for having got to run around. And I don't say that to embarrass him. I say that because I mean it. And
thank you, Don.
Well, I mean it, bud.
The women that I grew up with, I would gladly marry any of them and be happy. They're that kind of women. And I hope that if you look at the men in this class, they're all honorable, good, integral men. And I'm honored just to be a part of it. I love these guys, you know.
You're going to make me cry.
I have looked. You can look the world over. I've been all over this world, and you will never find people who are so loving and caring and adept. I would take this 30 people and conquer the world.
I nominate him for president.